Welcome, everyone, to Cornerstone Television Network. This is our Signs and Wonders program. We are so blessed that you have joined us today. I'm Pastor Gary Mitrick. We are with Pastor Myra Bell and Pastor J. Anthony Gilbert. And I am so glad there is no distance in the Holy Spirit. You know, Pastor Jay, I've been socially distancing from my refrigerator to lessen the curve on my stomach, but I didn't know I had to socially distance from you today.
Yeah, it is good. We do need to socially distance from our refrigerators, and it's good to be with you all, though, in this SD format. Social distancing format, and but like you said, there's no distance in the Holy Spirit, so Amen. We thank God for technology and the opportunity to be able to touch and agree for breakthroughs and miracles, signs, and wonders.
You doing well?
I'm doing very well. Family's doing great. Church is doing great. God spoke to me and said, this is not a time just to survive, but to thrive, and we are thriving, Pastor Amen. Gary and Pastor Myra.
Amen. Amen. Doing well as well. I thank God. You know what? I just... Bless God, because he's in control all the time. It's not something about distance. It's not about separation. We're in this together in spirit.
And we are going to get into some anointed worship to welcome the presence of the Lord. That's where God lives. He inhabits and dwells in the praises of his people. We are going to take communion together, so yes. We want you to get your elements, a cracker, a piece of bread, and some juice, so we can break bread together. It's always a great time, and then we're going to get into a word from the Lord. But Pastor Jay, an important part of Cornerstone Television Network from the very beginning, and for our Signs and Wonders program, is our prayer partners.
Oh, indeed, Pastor Gary, that's so true. And it's great to know that even in times like these, that the gospel of Jesus Christ is not only going across the airways, but the phone lines are not tied down. People can still call in. So the number comes up on your screen. Dial it in anytime, 888-665-4483. There are anointed prayer partners, even in the SD format, that are still ready live to come together in agreement with people to believe God for a breakthrough. We've got anointed prayer partners, Pastor Gary, that have been with us for many years, that are anointed, Holy Ghost filled, tongue talking, Bible believing, just powerful men and women of God that are ready to agree with people for supernatural breakthrough.
And Pastor Myra, Holy Communion is so significant for us in the life of a believer. What does taking communion mean to you?
It always causes me to remember, Pastor Gary, that Jesus did all of this for us. He gave his body and his blood so that we could be in fellowship with the Father. He took on himself the wrath of God, so we didn't have to. We don't have to deal with the wrath of God, but we can enjoy this abundant life.
Amen. So make sure you have your elements prepared. Pastor Jay, would you just lead us in a prayer welcoming the wonderful presence of the Holy Spirit here today?
Amen. I'd be honored. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you today. We welcome your sweet Holy Spirit right now. You said we're two or more are gathered in your name, there you'd be in the midst. So, Father God, we're touching and agreeing for the release of your word, the release of the anointing, the release of healing, your presence, your peace, whatever is needed, Father God. We pray that you would show up, Father, in this season, Father, and minister to each and every one of us. Anoint the song, anoint everything that goes on. And, Father, we declare that not one of us will leave the same way that we came, but that we will all leave changed and transformed by the power of your Spirit. For when we see you as we are, we will never be the same. And we thank you for it now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Well, to set the table for the word of the Lord, we're going to go to Pastor Rebecca Luker. She has a song that I pray is your testimony and mine. It's called My Soul is Anchored to the Rock.
Some men search forever for their place in this world. Others sell their souls for shiny diamonds and pearls. But temporary pleasures aren't my style. I want to make my living worthwhile. My soul will live forever and ever through all eternity. That's what really matters to me. Well, my soul is anchored to the rock of ages. My soul is anchored to the everlasting rock. Now I'm planted by the waters, fixed on solid ground. My heart is set on heaven, and my feet won't turn around. My soul is anchored, anchored to the rock. Secure since the beginning of time, weathered flame and flood by supernatural design, and like an old trusted friend, I know I can run to him time and time and time again. My faith does not depend on anything I achieve.
God will get us through the storms of life. I want to encourage you, if you have someone or something on your heart, please call 888-665-4483. Not only will the prayer partner pray with you, but we also are going to set ourselves in agreement for your breakthrough, your miracle. The God we serve said, "Is there anything too hard for me?" So I'm going to ask Pastor Jay and Pastor Meyer to help us break this word today. It's found in Matthew chapter 8, verse 5. It's a great story. It says, "Now, when Jesus had entered Capernaum, a centurion came to him, pleading with him, saying, 'Lord, my servant is lying at home, paralyzed and dreadfully tormented.'" Let's pause there for a moment. You know, so often, whenever we are battling physical conditions, it also, the enemy tries to put fear, torment, worry, stress in our minds. Pastor Jay, I always like to say the battleground for Satan is your mind.
That's right. He always wants to come at our minds, but you know, we have to combat him with the word of God and realize that no weapon formed against us is able to prosper. So it's important, Pastor Gary, you're so right. We have to have the word, especially in times like this, because even when heaven and earth passes away and things don't look well and things don't seem well, and we see all the changes in the economy, we take a look at all the stuff that's going on with COVID-19, we can always go back, even as the song was said, we can go back to the rock. We can go back to the word, and it will be a strong tower and a place of salvation for all of us.
Amen. All right, verse 7 says, and Jesus said to him, I will come and heal him. Pastor Myra, I always say God's will is in his word. When you and I are sick, when you and I need healing, it is absolutely, positively God's will that we believe and ask him for healing.
That's right. And he wants us to believe, not only believe, but press into a place that we know that his word is right, that his word will work. And that is the blessing in God's word.
Amen. There's power in the word of God. And verse 8 says, and the centurion answered him and said, Lord, I'm not worthy that you should come under my roof, but only speak the word and my servant will be healed. For I also am a man under authority, having soldiers under me. I say to this one, go, and he goes. To another, come, and he comes. And to my servant, do this, and he does it. And when Jesus heard that, he marveled and said to those who followed, assuredly, I say to you, I have not found such great faith, no, not in all of Israel. Pastor Jay, I love this story. This centurion had the faith for the Lord just to send the word. And if you and I could have that kind of faith, that we could just believe God to send his word to us, his word is not going to return void. It's going to accomplish what he sent it to perform.
And if we can just have that type of faith, just like the centurion servant, he said, listen, I'm not even worthy for you to come to my house. He understood. He saw in Christ Jesus the ability to just simply speak the word. He was a centurion, and he understood that if he just simply spoke it to his servants, then it had to be done. He saw that same thing in Jesus. And that's the powerful part. It's our revelation, Pastor Gary, of how we see Christ for ourselves that places a demand upon him. So whoever's watching right now, I don't know what you need, but ask God right now to open your eyes.
Come on.
That you might see all that Christ did for you, because he wants to give it to you. And then we place a demand by faith through the revelation of Christ Jesus in that area of our lives. And nothing that we ask for shall be impossible.
And Pastor Meyer, I want God to marvel at my faith, not at my doubt and unbelief.
Right. And it is just a wonder to be able to say to God, Lord, you have caused me to hope in your word. You've caused me because we understand his authority. And Pastor Gary, there are those several saints of the Most High God who, throughout this COVID, that are paralyzed like this man was, paralyzed with fear. But God has said, I will set you free. I will, looking at the I wills of God. And if we look into the will, because we have an inheritance in Christ. If we look into the will, we'll have all the things that are in the will of God.
Amen. And then verse 13 says, then Jesus said to the centurion, go your way, And as you have believed, so let it be done for you. And his servant was healed in that very same hour. You know, Mark 11, 24 says, we shall have whatever it is that we say if we don't doubt it in our hearts.
That's right.
And Pastor Jay, exactly what this centurion believed for his servant, who sounded like he was home on a lockdown. That's exactly the way God answered his prayer.
Amen. And I believe there's many people watching right now that you need to make a demand upon God in this moment, just like the centurion did. And I believe even by simply picking up the phone and dialing in, God, you know, a lot of times we try to figure out the end from the beginning and what's going to happen, all the steps. Just take the first step. You know, the centurion, he just reached out and said, hey, I believe that you're able. I tell my servant to go, he goes, and to another one, come, and he comes. If you'll just speak the word, the moment that his faith did it, it went into operation. And I just believe there's people watching right now, Pastor Gary, that as they call in, they're going to get something greater on the other side of the step. Something great is getting ready to happen for you, some supernatural move of God. You might pick up the phone and say, well, I don't know what's going to happen on it, but just take the step. God is in the season of a surprise, and I don't know what's going to happen when you take the step, but I believe it's not going to turn out like you thought. Things are going to be better than you thought, and God's ready to work a miracle on your life. Don't stay there paralyzed. Fear paralyzes, but faith mobilizes. We've heard it several times. God wants you to take a step of faith, mobilize, and when your faith gets mobilized, it mobilizes the power of God to annihilate whatever's coming against our lives. So pick up that phone now, 888-665-4483. Place a demand upon the faith and the word of God that is active right now.
Well, people are calling. Have you called yet? Come on, call right now. Let's agree together for the Lord to send the word, yeah, to heal you, to deliver you, to break bondages, addictions off of you. Yeah. Pastor Meyer, I believe God wants to break the spirit of fear and torment off of so many people today.
That's right. And if we will embrace the word of God and hold on to the word of God, the song said to anchor yourself, that you, if you anchor yourself in the word, because sometimes we will go to God in prayer, and then after we finish praying, we feel a little better. But then we go back and pick up what we were concerned about. Listen, God wants you free today. He wants you free right now in your home. Regardless of the fact that we have to be home, still give God glory and watch what he does.
Amen. Amen. Call that number, 888-665-4483. Let's get our communion elements together. If you have a cracker, a piece of bread, a cup of juice, let's ask the Lord to bless and sanctify these elements in Jesus Christ's name. Lord, it was on the night that you were soon about to be betrayed. You took bread, representing your very own body. For you were wounded for our transgressions. You were bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was on you, Lord. And with and by your stripes, we were and we are the healed. Yes. So take your bread, your cracker, take and eat of it now, and be healed in the name of Jesus Christ. Pastor Jay, would you pray over the cup for us?
Father, we thank you for this cup. We thank you, Father God, that it is symbolic of your blood that was shed, that not only brought the children of Israel out of bondage, but brings us out of slavery and makes us sons and daughters of the living God. So we receive your blood and we receive forgiveness. And Lord, we also forgive others that have done us wrong, that we will not walk in bondage, but walk in the same liberty that you have granted to us. So, Father, we receive the healing, deliverance, breakthrough, and blessing that you have afforded to us in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Take a drink of it now. and just sense God's healing presence going through your body, driving out pain. Somebody's joints have been real tight, restrictive. I just see God taking the oil can of heaven and oiling your joints today and healing you.
Jesus.
God, somebody else is setting you free. There's just a weight of heaviness, depression you've been battling. Lord, break it off.
Break
it off in Jesus Christ's name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Somebody else is being healed of migraine headaches right now.
In the name of Jesus.
Pastor Myra, just send the word. Just send the word to people right now to be healed and delivered. Come on, send the word.
God is going to, as you press into Him, you are going to receive greater than you ever expected God to do. This is a time for us to turn off everything else and believe what the report of the Lord is. And the report of the Lord is you are victorious. The report of the Lord is that you are an overcomer. You are what God says you are. Receive. Receive it. And it shall be done.
And Pastor Jay, if somebody's watching and they, maybe this type of a program, Christian programming, is new and different to them, maybe they don't have a personal relationship with the Lord, what would you say to them? Maybe they're just fearful with all the uncertainty going on in our world.
I would tell them, Pastor Gary, that it's not by accident nor by happenstance. But God loves you so much that He divinely positioned you, that you are watching us at this very moment, because He sent His Son over 2,000 years ago, because He knew times like this, people were going to need overcoming power. Jesus said that in this world, you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world. When you are in Christ Jesus, you overcome. It doesn't mean you don't go through things, but He causes you to be triumphant in every single circumstance. So right now, if you want Jesus Christ into your heart, you want to receive Him as your Savior, you want to be forgiven of your sins and walk in eternal life, pray this prayer with me right now. Say, Dear Father in heaven,
Dear Father in heaven,
I thank you today.
I thank you today
for your Son.
For your Son
that died for me.
That died for me.
I receive you now.
I receive you now
as my Lord.
As my Lord
and my Savior.
And my Savior.
Forgive me of my sins.
Forgive me of my sins.
Come into my heart.
Come into my heart.
And I will live for you.
And I will live for you.
As you show me how.
As you show me how.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Now, if you prayed that prayer, there's a number on the bottom of your screen. Pick up that phone. Dial that number, 888-665-4483. Let a prayer partner know you've stepped out of darkness. Now you're walking in the glorious light of Jesus Christ. He promised you, you'd be an overcomer. The Bible says that perfect love casts out all fear. His love is coming upon you today. Walk in it and know that if he did not spare His Son, how much more shall He freely give you all things? Romans chapter 5 says that you can have the abundant life. Walk in it today. God is for you.
And Eric called from Pittsburgh, dedicating his heart and life to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. There's a party in heaven, Eric. That's wonderful, wonderful news. Well, we've just got about a few minutes left. I'm going to ask each of us just to pray real briefly. Pastor Meyer, would you begin? I'm going to lay hands on the requests that have come in here on the altar.
Father, we thank you and we praise you that we can come boldly to the throne of grace. We can come boldly and make our requests known, and we do it with thanksgiving. All of the requests that have come in, you said that the peace of God would rule in the hearts. So, Father, we speak to each of these requests, and we ask you to have your way and be glorified in each of them in Jesus' name.
And Father God, we touch and agree with every single request. We thank you for breakthrough, signs, wonders, miracles, healings, provisions. Thank you, Father God, that we do send that word right now of healing, deliverance, Father. We send that word of freedom and peace, Father. Lord, that there'll be no fear. But Lord, we thank you that each person walks in your presence, in your glory, and we declare that there is no lack over any person's life. And Lord, you're sending your anointing to annihilate every thwart of enemy in Jesus' name.
And we send the word now to heal you, to drive out all fear, oppression, every negative thought. Yes. We cast down those strongholds in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And Lord, we join our faith together. We curse this coronavirus that it would dry up and die. We bind the python spirit. We cut the head of that snake off, that spirit of death, trying to strangle life out of people's health, out of the economy, and even out of the church. In Jesus Christ's name, amen and amen. Well, thank you for joining us today. Have a blessed day, and remember, stay encouraged.
In times of uncertainty, we need to focus on what is clear. And as believers, we can be absolutely certain that God has a perfect and unique purpose and plan for you and for me.
In times like these, His presence is everything. There's nothing like having that encounter, spending that alone, intimate time with Jesus when you feel the Holy Spirit moving on your heart.
God is faithful. He promises to never leave us or forsake us. He also promises to destroy our enemies and to save His people.
The unchangeable character of God is what will get us through every difficult time. When we're going through a time of uncertainty, like we've just been through, like we're going through right now, there is a God who is unchangeable.
And we know that our God is faithful. In Psalm 27, it says, I would have lost heart if I had not believed that I would see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. So wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and He shall strengthen your heart.
In these perilous times, we as believers must not forget the glorious privilege we have to go into the secret place to obtain protection, power, and provision to not just survive, but to thrive.
Your Father in heaven, who loves you so passionately, He's gonna provide for you, He's gonna protect you, He's gonna take care of you. You can trust in the faithfulness and the character of God.
Cornerstone Television wishes to thank all our faithful viewers whose consistent prayers and financial support have made this program possible.